Yo, what is up, guys? Today we're talking about Destiny 2. Now, specifically, we're going to be looking at the last set of weapons that came in the Season of the Worthy loot pool, or world loot pool, that is, which is the new Monarchy weapons. So, there is one new Monarchy weapon that I think is probably one of the best weapons in all of the weapons that I'm going to be reviewing, which is the grenade launcher, obviously, but I'll get to that when I get to that. Let's talk about GN 7 rifle, which is a pulse rifle, and I think it's fine. I think it's pretty cool. The roles that I got on it were, I think, like range finder and either Zen moment or I think grave robber, actually. So let's look at the perks. First one's going to be full auto trigger system, grave robber, disruption break, Zen moment, and firmly planted, with the second column being rampage, outlaw, swashbuckler, dragonfly, and rangefinder. So me personally, I would probably pair this with either fully auto trigger system and rangefinder, swashbuckler, or rampage, to be quite honest. I don't really value any of the other ones as much as I do like full auto trigger system, just because it just feels a lot more nice. But the role that I have, which was grave robber and rangefinder, is nice. I definitely see people valuing grave robber. I do see that. I just, me personally, if I'm not running something melee based like a titan or a specific role on my hunter, then I just really don't care, to be quite honest. Fully auto trigger system for me is just something that I can just click and then really just aim and just turn my brain off, kind of. It's more of a just kind of like a quality of life change for me. So that's why I value this a lot more. For the second row, it'd probably be like rampage, swashbuckler, or dragonfly, rangefinder, hell even. If I'm giving this to my titan specifically, I would probably go grave robber with swashbuckler, hands down. For my titan, it just feels a lot more fun because I'm usually aping it, so I usually am in that melee range. For my titan, I like to play a little bit more tactically, so like I'm not close to people usually, so that's why I don't value it on my hunter as much. But these roles, like, I like the combinations that you can do. Full auto trigger system is dope, grave robber is dope, disruption break could be really good if you use it wisely. And then rampage, swashbuckler, dragonfly, hell, rangefinder, all of those are really good. Outlaw, I think, should have been on the first row, but I can still see value in that. So yeah, I think this is a really good role. I think this could be really good for you. And that's really it. I don't have like a strong feeling of like I hate this or love it. It's just like right in the middle. Like, it's fine. It's a good weapon. There you go. So next one is going to be Honor's Edge, and this one is a heavy, and it's pretty interesting what you can get on it. So first, it's going to be Tireless Blade for the perks, Relentless Strike, and Energy Transfer. And then for the second row, it's going to be Counter Attack, Flash Counter, Surrounded, Shattering Blade, and On Guard. So this is where you guys are going to notice something about me. I actually don't know shit about swords. The only thing I do know is A, flash counter is only available in Honor's Edge. If I'm wrong, I'm going to be sad about that, but I'm pretty sure that's the only weapon you can get flash counter. And two, tireless weapons and counterattack are going to be what you're going to want to get those two specifically. I have Relentless Strikes. I like that a little bit more, because it gives you ammo after attack or after landing 3 light hits. And then counterattack, blocking an attack immediately after guarding increases damage for a short duration, which is nice. But I think flash counter is going to be a little bit better, because if you deflect melee, then the guard, you disorient and weakens the attacker. Like I said, I don't know much about swords, only that like Tireless Blade, Relentless Strike, Counterattack, and Flash Counter are like the four that you're going to be looking for the most. The other ones are really kind of like whatevers. I think Surrounded here has a lot more value than any other weapon, considering you're using a sword. But other than that, that's pretty much it. Yeah, I don't have a strong opinion about this one either, just because of the lack of knowledge I have on swords. If you guys have any knowledge on swords, let me know in the comments below. What would be your god role? Inform me, please, because I'm not going to tell. I'm not going to speak out of my ass and be like, oh, no, yeah, get energy transfer and on guard, even though they might be good. I don't know. So, yeah, I'm not going to lie to you guys. The next one is Interference VI. This is the weapon that fucking hell, really? This is the weapon that a lot of people are really trying to grind for, and you guys will see why in a minute. So it's not an aggressive. Aggressives got hit hard from a nerf this season, actually, if I remember correctly. And adaptive frames is what did not get touched at all. They still remain the same. I'm recalling this because this comes with spiked grenades and full court. So this is the new god roll, guys. This is the new one. If you guys want to use grenade launchers, this is what you're going to want to use. So let's look at the perks real quick. Obviously, spike grenades you're going to want. Now, it does change up here a little. If you're using spike grenades, but you're not using full court, you're going to want as low of an explosion as you can and more velocity. If you're using spike grenades with full court, you're going to want more explosions because of the full court. Just to get that out of the way, because the full court does more damage than the spike grenades, so you're gonna want more explosion damage for the full court. So any of the barrels that do more blast radius, so like confined launch, volatile launch, any of the things that give you more blast radius, you want that, just to get that out of the way real quick. So the first perk sets we're gonna look at is auto loading holster, field prep, clown cartridge, and grave robber. The last one's going to be demolitionist, swashbuckler, full court, and threat detector. So first and foremost, all three of these aside from grave robber are actually super viable. You could do auto loading holster for the immediate reload. Once you stow it, you can shoot all your load, switch to another weapon. Like for me, it would be like trophy hunter, do some boss damage from that, and then switch back to my grenade launcher to do more DPS. You could do field prep for the increase in ammo reserves, fast reload stow, and ready speed when you're crouching. Or you can do clown cartridge as well, which is actually pretty viable as well. You could get stupid fucking like amounts of magazine on like 8 or 9. So clown cartridge would be really good. For the last perk, it's going to be obviously full court. So PvE god roll is going to be spike grenades with volatile launch as your, let's start from the beginning. So volatile launch for your barrel, spike grenades for your magazine, either clown cartridge, field prep, or auto loading holster, with maybe field prep being the better one, and then full court. That would be the god roll to go for. I think I have the god roll. I'm not sure. I'm not off the top of my head at least, but I do know that I have a pretty good roll on mine. So I unfortunately, or fortunately actually, have counter mass with spike grenades, auto loading holster, and full court, which means that my blast radius is not as high as I could get it. It's just sad. But it's still pretty good. It's still really good, actually. The only thing I'm missing is my barrel. Other than that, everything else is perfect. And unfortunately, you can't really farm this one. This is a world drop, so the best you can do is just hope to God you get a roll that you want. I wanted clown cartridge instead of auto loading holster, but I'm not gonna lie, auto loading holster is still a really good one. So that's pretty much it for the videos. I was gonna make this all into one big fat video, but then I noticed that's 9 weapons, and the other video that I did about weapons, the 7 Seraph weapons, were only 6 and it took almost 20 minutes. I was like, I'm not going to do that. That's too much. So I decided to cut them up in 3 pieces. And if you guys notice, I'm trying to make it into 10 minutes. I don't know why. I'm not there yet, but it's like something I'm trying to do. But let me know what you guys think about the weapons. I personally love the Interference V1 or I, whatever, VI. I love it to death. It's one of my favorite weapons right now. Honor's Edge is interesting. I would love to like research wet swords more or watch more videos on swords. It's just that Outside from like specific activities, I really don't see or use swords. And then the GN7 rifle, again, a very mediocre weapon in my opinion. I like it. I have one, and it's so weird. I've never been so neutral on a weapon before. Like, it's like it has pretty cool roles. It's just, it doesn't like interest me. It doesn't like wow me. It's just like, it's a weapon. It exists. Like, it's here. Like, cool. So yeah, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Like I said, I enjoy making these videos. They are a ton of work to do, considering I have to do gameplay plus audio plus take the pictures plus it's a lot of fun to do these videos, especially like when I'm actually like really invested in some of the weapons. I'm planning on doing a few more weapon videos, like what pulse rifles to get, what SMGs to get, well, like kind of like that. Let me know in the comments if you guys would be interested. And yeah, thank you everyone for the constant support. I really do appreciate it. I really appreciate the people who actually watch my other content aside from Destiny 2. That's one thing that really hits home to me, because I want to do other content and I don't want to be stuck with Destiny 2. And I really appreciate it when other people just watch my other content. And if it's bad, let me know in a nice way. Don't be an asshole, but just let me know. Other than that, yeah, I'll see you guys later. Be safe. You guys know what's happening in the world. Don't cough in people's faces. Don't be an asshole. And other than that, I will see you guys later.